Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran and our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his authentic sunnah. We all know through Quran and sunnah that we are all transit to akhirah. We are all passing on. Sunnah or later, all of us will demise. All of us will leave this dunya, this short life of dunya. We will all pass and pass on to akhirah. And the life in akhirah is the real life. It is the better life. It is forever life. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. Akhirah is better for all of you than this dunya. This dunya, we live in problems. None of us is given everything. None of us is happy day and night in this dunya. Even if someone is happy sometime, it will make you unhappy other times. So this dunya is very short and it's not complete. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Yasin tells us that we will all pass on and we will all be resurrected, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look to our deeds, footsteps. Inna nahnu nuhyi al-mawta وَنَكْتُبُ مَا قَدَّمُوا وَآثَارَهُمْ وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ أَحْصَيْنَاهُ فِي إِمَامٍ مُبِينٍ. Everything is recorded in a kitab, in a book. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى وَنَكْتُبُ مَا قَدَّمُوا وَآثَارَهُمْ. Allah will record all that we have done in this dunya. مَا قَدَّمُوا, and then our footsteps. Salihan kan am talihan. Whether what you did were good or whether what you did were bad, they will be all written and recorded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you look to the sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will see that the deeds, the a'mal that we do are categorized into two. أعمال متعدية النفع وأعمال قاصرة النفع. أعمال, deeds that benefit others. أعمال that reach others. And أعمال that the reward is confined to the doer. Salat is a pillar. Fasting is a pillar. But this a'mal, the reward and the benefit is confined to you only. But then there are others that if you do, it will reach the community. It will reach the individuals. And what scholars say, أفضل العبادات أكثرها نفعا. The best deed that you do is the one that benefit others more. أفضل العبادات أكثرها نفعا. The one that make others happy, that is the ibadat that are more merited. That are more merited than the ibadat that the benefit is confined to the doer. Brothers and sisters in Islam, look to the prophets of Allah. Prophets of Allah were not sent to only preach or teach others, to preach and teach others ibadah only. They were not confined in mosques or synagogues or wherever. دور العبادات.
They were not confined, but they were out to benefit their communities in their life, world life, and in their akhirah. Nabiullah Yusuf alayhi salam, when there was a famine in his people, in Bani Israel, he was asked to look means and ways of alleviating poverty and famine from the community. The Quran says that how he planned that they come out of the famine. قَالَ تَزْرَعُونَ سَبْعَ سِنِينَ دَأَبًا فَمَا حَصَّدْتُمْ فَذَرُوهُ فِي سُنْبُلِهِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِمَّا تَأْكُلُونَ. Not only that, he reached where he became like a finance minister. اجعلني على خزائن الأرض إني حفيظ عليم. موسى عليه السلام, he saw two daughters of Nabiullah Shu'aib with their goats, cannot fetch water, cannot get water out of the shallow well. They couldn't go. First of shyness, they couldn't mix with men. Secondly, their father was very old. Say, وَأَبُونَا شَيْخٌ كَبِيرٌ. Our father is an old man. He couldn't help us. And we don't want to mix with men. And we are weak. Musa alayhi salam did what? He removed the stone. ثُمَّ سَقَى لَهُمَا حَتَّى رَوِيَةِ الْغَنَمِ فَسَقَى لَهُمَا ثُمَّ تَوَلَّى إِلَى الذِّلِّ. He helped them. Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as reported by someone who knew him better than all, Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha knew Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than anyone. He stayed with her the longest time. In the beginning of the revelation, the wahi, when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam thought that jinn touched him, that he was touched by a jinn, and he came back home saying, "Dathiruni, dathiruni." Khadija said, "Wallahi, ma yughzik Allahu abadan. Wallahi, Allah will never harm you. Allah will never do anything to you." Why? She mentioned what he used to do in his communities even before he became a prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wallahi ma yukhzik Allahu abadan, Allah will never harm you. Why? Innaka latasilu rahima wa tasdughu alhaditha wa tahmilu alkalla wa taghri adhayfa wa taksibu almaduma وَتَعِينُ عَلَى نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِّ. She mentioned his sifat, attributes that he used to do in Mecca. That you know, you knot ties with your relatives. You look after your relatives. That was before Islam, and it became after Islam. Especially if your parents are alive. If your father or mother are alive, you have your jannah in this dunya. وَغَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفْ. Don't tell them uff. Don't tell them anything that they will not like it. فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفْ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا واغفر لهما جناح الذل من الرحمة وقل رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. She says, إنك لتصل الرحمة وتصدق الحديث. You always tell the truth. وتغري الضيفة. You welcome your guests. وتحمل الكلة. You help the indigent, the needy. وتكسب المعدومة. the rare commodities in Mecca, he always used to bring it from Syria, from Sham. وَتَعِينُ عَلَى نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِّ. Now, نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِّ means that even if there was someone aggressive against in Mecca, Prophet ﷺ used to defend till he gets his back, his rights. That was Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. So prophets of Allah were not confined to be in preaching only, but also to benefit. That is why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in a very sound hadith narrated by Ibn Umar, and Sheikh Nasiruddin al-Albani mentioned it in the Silsila as-Sahihah, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Khayru nasi anfa'uhum linnas." The best of man is the best to mankind. The best among you is the best to mankind. خَيْرُ النَّاسِ أَنْفَعُهُمْ لِلنَّاسِ. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and even the Quran, in the Quran of Allah, Kitab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we all know that we pass on and we go to the grave. That grave is either Jannah, حفرة من حفر النار, أو روضة من رياض الجنة. It will be a dwelling of Jannah or a hall of fire, of punishment. And even there is عذاب القبر والعياذ بالله. There will be punishment in the grave. سورة السجدة ولنذيغنهم من العذاب الأدنى دون العذاب الأكبر لعلهم يرجعون. وَلَنُذِيغَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى. عَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى is عَذَابُ الْقَبْرِ وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. While you are in that unique and lonely life, in your grave, there are deeds that will reach you in the grave. أعمال that will come to you in the grave. When all the deeds you are doing in this dunya, it will cut off. Hadith of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, إِذَا مَاتَ الْإِنسَانُ إِنْقَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثٍ. إِنْقَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ. All your deeds will stop. Except what Prophet ﷺ mentions in so many hadiths. إِذَا مَاتَ الْإِنسَانُ إِنْقَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثٍ. مِنْ صَدَقَةٍ جَارِيَةٍ أو مِنْ عِلْمٍ يُنْتَفَعُ بِهِ أو من ولد صالح يدعو له. And hadith of Abu Hurairah in Ibn Majah, Sheikh Nasiruddin al-Albani says, hadith sahih, إِنَّ مِمَّا يَلْحَقُ الْمُؤْمِنَ. What will reach you in the grave out of the deeds you used to do in this world? إِنَّ مِمَّا يَلْحَقُ الْمُؤْمِنَ مِنْ عَمَلِهِ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهِ عِلْمًا نَشَرَهُ أو وَلَدًا صَالِحًا تَرَكَهُ أو مصحفا ورثه أو مسجدا بناه أو بيتا لابن سبيل بناه أو نهرا أجراه أو صدقة أخرجها في صحته وحياته تلحقه بعد موته. These are أعمال, deeds that will reach you in the grave. إن مما يلحق المؤمن من عمله بعد موته علما نشره. علم that you gave out. علم that, علم is very important. Especially Islamic knowledge. We all need to know the Islamic knowledge. عِلْمًا نَشَرَ. Either you open madrasa, you sponsor a muallim to teach kitab of Allah. خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. If you teach Al-Quran, you are the best. And the ilm, the best ilm, the right ilm is علم القرآن والسنة. Imam al-Shafi'i says, Al-ilmu, qala Allahu, qala Rasuluhu, wa ma siwa thalika wiswasu shayateen. Ilm is Allah said in the Quran, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in his sunnah. That is the ilm. Ilm al-nashara. O waladan salihan taraka. A boy, a girl, a daughter, or a son, that you gave them good tarbiyah. You gave them tarbiyah. And when you demise, They will make dua for you. There's hadith narrated by Imam al-Shawkani, Muhammad ibn Ali al-Shawkani in Fath al-Qadir, that the hadith says, إن الله ليرفع الدرجة للعبد الصالح. Allah elevates the benevolent good Muslim in his grave from the situation he was to a better one في الجنة, in the grave, روضة من رياض الجنة. فيقول يا ربي, oh Allah, من أين لي هذا, how can I get this, how can I get this now. فيقول باستغفار ولدك لك. The hadith is Hassan hadith narrated by Abi Huraira, and Imam Shawkani mentioned it in the Fath al-Qadir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, باستغفار ولدك من بعدي. ولد هنا is a boy or a girl. Those whom you left in dunya, they are making dua for you. They are saying, oh Allah, forgive our father. Oh Allah, forgive our mother. Oh Allah, give them Jannah. Oh Allah, that is what will reach you in the grave. Oh waladan salihan taraka. Oh mushafan warratha. A mushaf that you gave and you put in a masjid that Muslims can read. As long as that mushaf is in the masjid, you will get the reward. Even the reward will reach you in the grave. Oh mushafan warratha. Oh masjidan bana. A masjid that you participated. Look this masjid today. Look, brothers, this masjid. How was this area before this masjid? Not only it's a beautiful masjid, not only that it is a mosque of Allah that we are doing ibadah, but it raised Islam to another level in this area. And who built it? It's you who built it. The family gave the plot, and Muslims contributed to have this mosque that you see today. And those who contributed, some of them may pass it on already. They are getting the reward in the grave. And those of you who are alive, hadith of Uthman ibn Affan, man bana lillahi baytan fi dunya, bana Allahu lahu baytan fil jannah. Whoever contributed building of this mosque, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you a house in Jannah. And this is a ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh, baytan libni sabili bana, or a house for those Muslims, needy Muslims who are traveling, where they rest and eat. If you do that also, that will reach you in the grave. أو صدقة أخرجها من ماله في صحته وحياته تلحقه بعد موته. أو نهرا أجراه. أو صدقة أخرجها من ماله في صحته وحياته تلحقه بعد موته. نهرا أجراه means borehole, shallow well. Today, millions of Muslims are starving out of lack of water. Millions of Muslims are starving. They have nothing. 2,000 shilling can save a family. When we go to a coffee shop and we take coffee with 2,000 shilling, and it can save a family, a Muslim family, take them out of death or danger. Muslims, we need to think that we need to provide water to our brothers and sisters, wherever they are, who need water. This is the best sadaqah that you can give, if you give water, if you give out water. Oh, general sadaqah that you give from your mal, your wealth, when you are in good health, fi sihati wa hayati, and when you are alive. Not when you feel that you are leaving this dunya, then you say, I will give sadaqah, this is for this, no. When you are healthy, give out for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers, These deeds that will reach you in the grave are not confined only in one hadith. There are very many. You can sponsor an orphan. You can sponsor a widow. You can sponsor a da'iyah, preacher. You can sponsor madrasat of Al-Quran. You can give out food. You can give out ration to needy indigent, needy Muslims. It's not. And that is what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned. And that is what the Sahaba after him used to do. Also, da'wah, teaching our young, preparing them to be the second line. Almost all the ulama of this ummah are passed on. There are no more ulama. And the second line is not ready yet. As-Saffi Thani. Who will take this da'wah? Who will give out this da'wah? Inna Allah la yaghbidu al-ilma. انتزاعاً ينتزعه من صدور الناس ولكن يقبض العلم بقبض العلماء حتى إذا لم يبقى عالم في الأرض اتخذ الناس رؤوسا جهالا فسئلوا فأفتوا بغير علم فضلوا وأضلوا. We need also to give da'wah, to teach the young generation to teach. That is why if you teach your boys and girls at home, when you demise, they will make dua for you and you will get the reward from their dua. Mus'ab ibn Umair, a very young boy, in his 20s, Mus'ab ibn Umair al-Abdari, bay'at al-Aqaba thaniya, the second bay'at al-Aqaba, he came with some Ansar. That time Medina was known as Yathrib. There was Al-Aws and Al-Khazraj, two clans. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam brothered them and called them Al-Ansar. Changed from Yathrib to Al-Madina, Al-Munawwara. Mus'ab ibn Umair, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent him to Medina, Safiran bil-Quran. Take the Quran, teach the people of Medina the Quran. We will come, one day we'll come to you, we'll reach Medina. Mus'ab went to Medina al-Munawwar. He started teaching Al-Quran. Aws and Khazraj, they have a club, Nadi. The leader was called Sa'd ibn Mu'adh. He'd say to the people of the Nadi, there is a boy in Medina. He brought a deen which is not our deen. I need someone to stop that boy or even take his life. Usayd ibn al-Hudayr was a relative of Sa'ad, said, let me go. He went to kill him, to eliminate him. But he knew Arabic. When he listened the ayat, immediately became a Muslim. He came back. Sa'ad saw that he's a changed man. Say, wallahi, لقد عاد بوجه غير الوجه الذي ذهب به. He came with a face that is not the face when he went. He said, brother, go and listen to that man. Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh went to Mus'ab ibn Umair, listened the Quran, he became a Muslim. He came back to the club, the Nadi. He said, man ana lakum, whom am I to you? They said, you are our master. He said, I want all of you to revert to Islam. All of you to come to Islam. That night, the scholars of Tariq say, only few houses remained. The whole Medina became Muslims that night. All Medina. That is the da'wah of Mus'ab ibn Umair al-Abdari, a young boy, a young man. What about if all of us give da'wah to all these communities? If every one of us, starting with your maid, starting with your driver, you all take them to Islam, give them the shahada, this area and this country will all be Muslims. I know most of you are not aware that nearly 180 years ago, there was no single Christian in this country, either a Muslim or an atheist, a pagan. Then the Muslims were forced. And the people you see, majority of them most of them, their grand-grannies were Muslims. We need to take them back to Islam. We don't convert them to Islam. We revert them to Islam. We bring them back to Islam because their origin was Islam. But we are not doing that. These deeds that we do, brothers and sisters in Islam, Abu Huraira, likes of Abu Huraira who passed it on, they are alive. Abdullah ibn Salih al-Farisi passed it on, he is alive. Abu Muhsin al-Barawani passed it on, they are alive. With the knowledge they left, the time is very short. Inshallah we will continue with this dersa, but you have to know that people, there are people who pass it on, but they are alive. And there are people who are alive, but they are dead. قَدْ مَاتَ قَوْمٌ وَمَا مَاتَتْ مَكَارِمُهُمْ وَعَاشَ قَوْمٌ وَهُمْ فِي النَّاسِ قَدْ مَاتَ قَوْمٌ وَمَا مَاتَتْ مَكَارِمُهُمْ وَعَاشَ قَوْمٌ وَهُمْ فِي النَّاسِ أَمْوَاتٌ. There are people who are alive, but they are dead.